I'm Chief Master Sergeant Andy Rapsavage, the Senior Enlisted Leader for the 341st Munition Squadron. What it means to be a Chief Master Sergeant to me is it's an institutional leader, a trusted advisor to commanders, somebody who's there that supports and removes barriers and obstacles for mission accomplishment, somebody who takes care of their teammates through experience, you know, advise them on career paths. We're networked, so if they're having issues in other squadrons, they need assistance, you know, chiefs can reach out to other chiefs and then, you know, they will work with their personnel, hopefully resolve issues. The mentors that really prepared me to become a chief, none of them were chiefs. So, like, people like, you know, there's Tech Sergeant Carlson, I had, you know, Staff Sergeant Brack, Tech Sergeant Sed Watson. These people were very critical at a very early stage. You know, I found that the people that really set me on the right path was when I was an airman. You know, they were the most developmental people. So my staff sergeants, the tech sergeants I worked for, they were very big mentors of mine. And then, you know, as I progressed into an NCO, people like Tech Sergeant Olson, he was a big mentor of mine. Tech Sergeant Cindy Heiss, you know, they kind of taught me what it means to be an NCO. And then, you know, towards the end of your career, when you're a senior NCO, then you start getting people like, you know, I had Colonel Craycraft was a huge influence on me when I was in the USAF EIG, as well as Chief Stanley. You know, they kind of put a lot of polish on me to kind of get me ready for that next position. And, you know, Chief Waldo, he was also a huge, he was somebody to aspire to. Find your peers that are smartest at what they do and surround yourself with them. You know, because like you're always fighting like, oh, do I hang out with the cool people or do I hang out with the, you know, the party people? And it, for me, it was always like, hey, find the people that are the best at their job and surround yourself with them. So to me, the biggest thing that I've struggled with in my career, right, is finding balance. And I think a lot of us do. You know, when I was an airman, I'd work as many hours as I possibly could because I was trying to establish a reputation, you know, and then that becomes a huge part of, you know, how you present yourself, you know, you spend a lot of time building that reputation, you know, you get protected. So, you know, then, you know, when I was an NCO, I went to Buchel and I would essentially work, you know, from 5 o'clock in the morning till 8 o'clock at night. And I did that for 4 years, right? So the constant, and what I learned was, you know, I didn't have balance. And the people that suffered for that were, they were my family. My son, you know, he went through his entire school career and I think I went to 2 events in his entire, you know, from first grade all the way to being a senior, like 2 events and that's it. And my daughter wasn't a whole lot better, you know, so if I could give any advice, you know, it's find balance between work and your family, because that's stuff you can't get back. You know, that time that I lost with my kids is gone. The people I'd like to thank, I'd start with the Wing 1 leadership team, Colonel Fugate-Opperman, Colonel Voorhees, and Chief Becker. You know, I know that their support was instrumental to, you know, to my success at this installation. Colonel Benton and Chief Baker. I know Chief Baker did a lot of work to help posture me for success here. Their support was very critical. And then, of course, you know, my squadron command team, Major O'Neill and Major Lovelady, you know, also very critical to success for me. I'd like to thank my family. They sacrificed a lot, you know, to get me to where I'm at. So, you know, without their support, definitely would not be here. And then finally, you know, my mom and dad were very important. You know, my dad, he passed away in 2019, but he was probably my biggest cheerleader throughout my career. So I know that without their support, I would also not be here today.